thank you. You know, you're all my peers, and so it's always a pleasure to be in front of my peers. A lot of things that we do, I take different drills, and I try to use my own personality and my own style when I coach. So does anybody here sometimes have a large group and you got to get people going right off the bat? Okay, so we're going to do that. You can do this with 16 people. Okay, go ahead and get started. We're going to do this. This is called a bump volley, okay? And basically, they're going to catch it on their racket, and then they're going to move and touch the net. And anytime you volley, I love you moving towards the net. Now, the big key is if they don't hit it in the middle of the service box, this isn't going to work. So a lot of times, I did a clinic in Texas with some high school kids that were actually in supers pretty good, and they had a hard time getting 10 in a row doing this. You could eventually do it. I could do this with my PE classes. You can dumb this down. But to me, I love to warm up the hands, the eyes, and the feet. And again, when I volley, I want you moving towards the net. A lot of times when they volley, they move back or their feet are stopped. So notice doing this, their feet are moving and they're moving nonstop. You could do this. I like to keep score with everything. So if I had 16 people, I could have these four versus these four, and then I could have those other four and we could have a competition. So you could literally do this with 16 people on a court. You could do this the first 2 minutes of your practice and say, okay, what's the record or how many can you get in a row? All right, now you're gonna go cross court. And doing this, I want them to move with the flow of the ball, so they're gonna touch the net to the side that they hit. So there you go, Chloe, good. So as they hit, they're gonna move in the direction of the ball. Anytime you volley, a lot of times we go on the opposite. We wanna be on the same side as the ball is, so get used to moving that direction. You could actually do this actually cross court, but right now we're just doing forehand to forehand. I love to be on top of the net. I think I've said this a couple times. Now, the reason I love to be on top of the net is anybody can do it, okay? Now, I was a junior in high school at a college camp, and this coach is feeding me balls, and I'm on top of the net crazy, and he's like, Kim, that was awesome. But anybody can volley from there. I need you to volley from back there. And I go, exactly right. All right, do backhands now, but do it with a cross-court angle now. Stop for a second. Cross-court angles, we're coaches. There you go. Backhand, no, Chloe, stay there. There you go. So this coach is like, well, anybody can do that. And I go, that's right, but in doubles, when you're playing doubles, you need someone on top of the net. All right, who do I have as a volunteer real quick? Come on, jump on out here real quick. While they're doing this right here. And again, you can do this different directions. Stand right here on the service line. I probably picked the wrong person because he's a little taller than me. How much can you see over the net in the court?
About a foot or two beyond
that. Okay, so you can see about a foot or two.
That's not me. That's
a
fire alarm.
Can you hear me? Okay. So the idea, that's good. Thank you. Is it Daniel? Devin. Thank you, Devin. Whoa. And that's a little loud again there, too. And this is still going to beep, so I guess it's not. Okay. All right. It's not me. All right. Okay. So the idea is that when you're playing doubles, you want your club players, you want even our lead players, we want you on top of the net. Okay. We want to get as close as we can because you want to be able to put the ball away the first or second ball. If you're volleying from back here, this is where you'll make a first volley, but you're just keeping it in play. You're not winning the point. If I'm up there close to the net, I got a great chance to win the point, okay? So that's gonna be one of the concepts that a lot of people will tell you, don't get on top of the net, but I'm gonna say get on top of the net all that you can. Next thing is I always play in practice, so even when I was a teaching pro, and then afterwards, I might take that note card and then in the evening write a few notes, and to the next lesson I would know what to build on. Okay, so if I pull this out a couple of times, that's why I'm doing it. All right, let's do the no-brainers at the feet. Or, not no-brainers. Half of you, two over there, two over here, two here. Okay, two at the net, two at the net. Service line, find the feet. All right, the next thing, you're at the net, Tim, Tosh. You're at the net. Two at the net, there you go. Two at the net, there you go. You can just toss the ball so you can keep. All right, you're switching out. JoJo, you're right behind her. Oh, you're right. All right, what they're gonna do next, because I like to teach getting on top of the net. Okay, this side here is gonna volley, and they're trying to find their feet, okay? And so a lot of times there's like, you gotta work on volleying deep. No, you gotta work on volleying short. If a team's coming in, you gotta find their feet. If a team is staying back, then you wanna volley short because you wanna find their feet. So right now the volleyers are staying on top of the net and they're trying to hit down on the ball. And so we actually practice this. The people on the far side are trying to hit half volley. So anytime the ball bounces, a lot of times at the service line, a lot of players, they like to turn under and hit underspin. If you pop that up, a good player will be all over that ball. So that's why they're working on dropping the racket head low and getting underneath that. And like I said, a lot of people are like, oh, I don't want you on top of the net. I'm like, yeah, I want you on top of the net, okay? The other people there, again, are trying to keep it cross court. So we've got nine people right here. We could keep this going with nine people if we only had one court where we got stuck. If we have four people in four to a court, this works awesome. And they're just rotating around there. All right. Anybody any questions on that? Okay. Go ahead and stop here. Let's say y'all pull back to no man's land. We're going to do figure eight. Let's just have two and two right now. Figure eight. Okay. All right. Since we're talking about doubles, this side's going to be cross court. That side's going to be down line. This is a simple, simple drill. We can do this with no man's land warming up. They've already warmed up, or we can do it at the service line. We can do it no man's land. We can do it at the baseline. This side's hitting cross court. That side's hitting down the line. When they do this, we're trying to get by the single sideline. If they leave the ball towards the middle, the team that does it can hit it with topspin right at the tee. So ground strokes can be at the tee if there's a hole. But right now, this is a great drill for singles or for doubles because it keeps it out of the hole. And if a singles player leaves the ball in the hole, they're killed. But in doubles teams, you gotta make a move. The big concept here, when we do some other drills, is move with the ball, move with your partner. A good doubles team is on each other's half. You don't have one on this half and one on that half. They're on each other's half. So notice that she left the ball there towards the middle. She could hit the inside shot. She can drive it at the tee, okay? This is a good one for decision-making if you're working with juniors, but adults can do this one too. And they've gotten a lot better because we used to do this and every ball used to be right down the middle of the court. And now they know they're gonna have to pay for it if they don't get it out there wide. But the other concept, and we're gonna get to this with the doubles, if you change the direction in doubles, you are moving. The only time to change the direction of doubles is when you can hurt them and look to finish the point, okay? So that's why they kind of realize, oh gosh, I gotta move a whole lot, good pickup, if I do this, okay? And again, you can do this at the service line, you can do this at no man's land, you can back up and do this from the baseline. All right, let's set it up with no brainers. Now, one of our systems is everybody tells you to volley at the tee, right? In doubles, anybody ever heard that? Hey, you need to volley at the tee? No? Okay. Well, I tell you what, all my kids here, they've been taught, you volley at the tee, you volley at the tee, you volley at the tee. And I'm like, I don't want you volleying at the tee. I want you volleying at the V, okay? And the V is, coach just made a V right there, okay? So, y'all can come on down this end, or... Actually, no, y'all wait down there, you'll be the ground strokers. Okay. So he did a V with these single sticks, and this is what I'm going to tell you too. A lot of clubs have single sticks. We use single sticks for serving. We use single sticks for returning. We use single sticks for targets. So you can use these single sticks that designate the area. So she's going to go outside the V and follow the direction. We get them close to the net. So this would be the server's net person. We put them pretty close to the center, and we want them to float and go get it. So they're trying to hit the racket bag. All of your, if you're teaching pros at clubs, you have those racket bags. Most of the times those kids don't want them. I take them for my players. We use them as targets. Same thing, super easy targets. I don't have to buy targets. And then when I have summer camps, I give them to the little kids and they think they won the lottery, okay? All right, so that's going outside the V. And any, this is, who's heard of Paul Wardlock? Okay, so there's directionals. Directionals on the volleys, okay? Basically what it means is that when I'm reaching and I'm gonna hit the inside, if I gotta reach out here wide, I'm gonna move and hit the inside edge. I'm not gonna try to change the direction. If the ball's coming at me, I'm gonna go with the flow of the ball. All right, coach, go ahead and feed with pace down the line, or cross court, pace with cross court. So he's gonna feed with pace, and now they're gonna go cross court. So notice that we're not hitting at the tee at all. We're trying to hit short, and we're trying to win the point right off the bat, okay? And we're gonna give you a different variety of drills because these would be the dead ball drills, okay? And then coach, go ahead and do it with two balls. So now he's gonna go cross court and then down the line because we want you to move with the flow of the ball. The very first drill that we did is, even though it was mini tennis, you're moving with the flow of the ball. So he goes cross court and she goes with the flow of the ball. Because how many times in doubles the ball floats right by the net person's nose and they didn't do anything because they're afraid to move. So we get their feet moving that they're not afraid to go get. We probably practice 50% volleys. On 50% volleys and overheads is 50% of our practice every day, okay? All right, coach, now go down the line and then cross court. So we're either gonna go and cover the line or we're going to, or I'm sorry, we're gonna go and go cross court or we're gonna stay and cover the line. So right now this would be, hey, we stayed and covered the line and now the ball floats and now we go get it. So right there, she missed her directional. She should have gone the inside edge. So the inside edge is the only spot you have to reach on that outside floater. And so if they go down the line, we're good, okay? And it just gets them moving. All right, now let's go ahead and set up. We'll do a little competition, okay? Coach, you're gonna feed down here, okay? Y'all are the ground strokers. Move those balls right back there, okay? Now we're gonna do it, the volleyers versus the ground strokers. We might play to five, we might play to eight, okay? Coach is gonna feed a ball. They've gotta hit a ball cross court, and they're gonna hit their no-brainer, okay? So now we're getting a little bit more live ball. Okay, so she got in the V, not bad. As the ball bounces, they're gonna stand up. She's down, she's gonna stand up and then move to the ball as the ball bounces. And what we like to do again when we volley is if we volley short and we're on top of that net, we're gonna get that first ball. So we like, she didn't get close enough and she let the ball drop. So the second ball we drill with a half volley, she didn't do a good job. You gotta relax the eyes, see it, and go get it. That ball's a winner right there. The ball's over on one shot, okay? So we might have a competition against the ground strokers, and if like they would be up 1-0 because we missed the volley. If the ground strokers can get it, it would be 1-1 right there. So again, finding a climate to create competition, whether you're doing how many consecutive ground strokes can I hit, or can I beat the ground strokers versus the volleyers, beat them. All right, coach, come on up and serve. Now we're gonna come on up. You're still going? You're still going? All right, now we're gonna add it with a serve. So all he's gonna do is serve out wide, and they're gonna return. Now, I'm gonna go back. Lily, do me a favor, go grab me two of those single sticks. All right, go ahead, Natty, for a second. She's going cross court, a little late. When the ball bounces on the other side, our net person's gonna stand up tall and look to hug the net and go get it, okay? Now, the other thing in doubles is we like to teach singles targets. So the ball before we missed because we went for the double sideline. If I'm aiming at the singles target and I hit that there, we're gonna win the point. So these are all the same drill. We might do a different drill every day, but all the same concept, and we call these no-brainers. We're working on doing the same thing, the same way, every single time, okay? All right, Chloe, you got those sticks? You got the sticks, Chloe? Oh, you didn't bring them. Okay, go bring them. All right, go set them up for the V. All right, one of the things that I'm not gonna get into a lot of technique on the return, but again, this is how you can use the sticks. She's gonna set them up at a V, and her feet are gonna be on the sticks. And a lot of times, most players step backwards on the return. If you're stepping backwards on the return, you're gonna hit the ball late. There's two reaction shots in tennis. One is a volley, and the other is a return. So on the return, you better be stepping forwards, and you better have your eyes forward. They're here, and they're looking for a load, just like Kent talked about, a load, and then going into the court, okay? So we could use these here. If you only had one stick, that was a great return, Lily. Now, probably 6 months ago, that little girl right there, she was probably 10 feet behind the baseline every time she hit a return. But use the stick so that way you can get the feet and they can feel the feet stepping forward. When the ball bounces, the net person will stand up and then they'll go stay with it, soft. Oh, that was our mini tennis. Okay, that could be an outside ball. But that way we're incorporating serves and returns while we're doing it. You can serve, they can serve, however you want to do this here. All right, let's go ahead and stop here for a second. Y'all reload some balls back down there for a second. So let me kind of explain one thing. In doubles, if my partner is serving, we're gonna put our partner right up here, about a racket's length from the center service line. And we're gonna be facing the angle of the ball, and when the ball bounces, we're gonna stand up and we're gonna try to go. If I'm going, I'm gonna cut this off here. I can get 98% of the balls. If they hit that shot, I say, great shot. If I'm gonna cover down the line, I just cheat about a foot with my step, then I'm gonna go and I'm gonna get here. But we're always moving at angles and we're always moving towards the net. I see volleyers, they move back and it just drives me crazy, okay? The angle is angles and it's towards the net. So there's about five different drills that you could do right there, all the same drill, but you add from a dead ball to a live ball, okay? All right, now we're gonna have the returner go down the line, okay? Y'all are down there returning, and the net person. Coach is serving. All right, we're gonna go two concepts with returning, and we're gonna talk about the returner's net person. We're gonna put the returner's net person, they should be okay, at the tee, cover the middle more, hug that middle more, okay? If I'm gonna go down the line's a great return if you can hurt her, particularly in the women's game or in women's tennis, because you can hurt them. And again, a lot of people don't practice volleys. And I know when I was a teaching pro, all the ladies were afraid of getting hit in the face. I don't wanna get hit in the face, okay? So, but it's a great return when you compete and play. Now, Tasha's eyes, this is Tasha right here, wave your hand, Tasha, okay? Tasha's eyes are gonna be at the server's net person. Coach is the server and the server's net person. He's gonna be both. He's just gonna serve from there, okay? The returner's going to isolate, we call that isolate, and they're gonna go down the line. Remember the very first drill we said, or the third drill we said, move with the ball, move with the partner. So if she's going down the line, Tasha needs to be hugging and be on her half, ready to pick that ball off, okay? Now, my next thing is, how many times when the ball goes at the tee, where does the ball typically go? So if I'm gonna volley right at Tasha, let me see a ball, yeah, right her, it typically goes right back here, right? And who's on top of the net? I am. Where is she? She's back there, she's keeping it in play, I'm winning the point, okay? I'm winning the point, I'm on top of the net. The person on top of the net wins the point. Okay, so what we have worked on doing is when that ball, their eyes are at the net person, if they volley at them, they're gonna volley short over here. If they volley short over here, 8 out of 10 times it's a winner because this person is still back here and they don't run for that ball right there if it lands in the service box. Now, if she volleys back here deep, then I'm in good shape. All right, let's see it, Tosh. Let's see what you got. So she go down the line. Good. That's a winner right there. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. And so what we're doing, and also move your feet with the flow of the ball. So when you get up here, Lily, move up with the ball. Move with the flow of the ball when you do it. So we train that. She's gonna move the ball. You can do that if they miss it. You can have two balls and you can feed it. So notice she missed the return and he fed it. Or more advanced players with our players, when they miss it, I go, you lose. You're done. They don't get to practice because you didn't make them good enough. Okay? You gotta make them hit the ball in order to get good enough. I should have you do it on the other side, Coach. Good. All right, let's have you do it on the other side real quick. Let's have you turn on the other side real quick. No, Coach, you're right here. You're right here. They're just gonna volley that. There we go. We'll keep you safe. Okay? But again, you can vary drills. Like I said, right now is if they miss, he can feed in a ball. If they don't miss, then you can say, sorry, get better, make your partner, make them better, okay? But also notice from the very first drill, they're moving. Oh, she didn't move forwards. Mary. Come on, Mary. Come on, show me, woman. There you go, Lily. Lily, move forwards. We want the eyes looking and going, Okay, and you can stick some too if you want, coach. Okay, that was a little deep, so that way they're gonna get in trouble. All right, now we're going to stop, okay? So the returner's net person's eyes is at the server's net person. They're looking at them being ready for this ball, okay? Now when we return, scoot up there, Lily, good, and the middle box. All right, now where we're gonna return, and we were in Seattle, and we were at sea level, and we're probably, we're returning from inside the 10 and under line. Remember, we're playing women's tennis. We're not gonna hurt you with the serve, even at the college level. Maybe one or two. We're returning from here. We're hitting a great return. If my net person, coach, go stand on the tee for a second. If my net person is right there and I hit a great return, is he gonna be able to put the ball away? Probably not, because he's in the safety zone. He's in keep it in play. And that's the problem, is most people try to win the point from there. So coach, scoot up in the middle of the service box. I'm confident, it's a second serve. I'm confident I'm gonna get away from the net person. Now I'm gonna put him here, and now we go back to that no-brainer drill where we've fed him the floater. Now he's gonna be able to pick that ball off, okay? The only time we have our returner's net person, right here, come back here, is if we're really struggling getting the ball past the net person, or we're not isolated. So sometimes we do it on purpose, but if I'm not doing it on purpose and I can't get him past, that's when I'd have my net person there. But if not, we're gonna start the match way up here, okay? So we're gonna do the same thing, okay? And JoJo, come on, you're gonna be there, you're gonna volley. So right now, just imagine the net person right there is the returner's net person, okay? And they're gonna, what we call this is crowd and go. Just feed a volley. So you volley, and you volley back. Yeah, so you have two balls. So he's gonna feed them a volley, they come in. Good, that's a good no-brainer. So right now, again, that volleyer back there is working on keeping in play for the first volley, okay? And then he can feed them too. Last week in practice, we wouldn't feed them too, so now they're not looking for it. And I'm like, you weren't making them any better. You gotta make them hit that first ball. So you can put expectations on it. Okay, that's a bad ball because it went right at the tee. That ball can come back. That's a great ball. But they look for it and they try to get it. That's flirting right there because we want the single sideline. Well, no, you still should be going. No, because if you hit cross court where you should be hitting, that's why I'm not having it this direction. Tosh, I thought of that one. There we go. She's like, oh, we gotta keep him out of it. He was making the volley so good, they had to hit the inside edge with the directionals, okay? If he doesn't make them that good, they're gonna go back, but she wants a bigger target. So again, this is another drill. You can do this with teaching pro. You can do this with four people. You can do this with, we got nine people right there, and you can get them moving enough. Okay, so different variety of drills to work on them going. And again, I think the biggest key to get the net person going is just feeding them balls where you have to get used to going after the ball. That's why we do this all the time. And then any of these drills, if you want, I'll send them to you by email. They locked the office last night, so I couldn't get into the printer. So I can email these because I have them all online. So, all right. Any questions on that? A little bit different, and I'm doing okay on time. All right. So we're volleying short, we're volleying outside the V, and we're moving in the direction of the ball. Those are our three components when we play doubles. And putting that net person up there close and up there tight. Do you think anybody's gonna have people that would be afraid to get up there close? Okay, and I know working even some with my ladies, they will. They actually were afraid to get up there close, okay? So how we started off doing this to get them acclimated, the Nerf balls, we did everything with the Nerf balls. And we let them hit it, and then they realized they were actually getting the ball over 85% of the time, and they weren't getting hit when they were looking for it. It's kind of like a shortstop. Let's do a quick pickup real quick. It's kind of like a shortstop in baseball. You know, the net person is you're trying not to get the ball back there, and you got to be looking to go forward. So if you're afraid and you're doing this, you're going to get hit. If you're playing burnout and you do this, you're going to get hit in the face or break a finger. Okay, but if you go and you make your hands forward. So we started doing this to acclimate them, doing it with Nerf balls, just to let them know. And then they got really good, and then they weren't as afraid. So just to let you know, that's something that you could add, particularly if you're working with ladies groups. But I can tell you, if you work on getting on top of the net, you'll just see an amazing difference of how many balls they're going to get. And then they're like, oh, I just hit a winner. You know, like, oh, I'm volleying great. Because once again, anybody can volley from the surface, from the net. So, any questions? All right. Next thing, we're going to talk about our system. Coach, do you want to go set up the V over there? Huh? No, not yet. Okay. We're going to set up the V over there. And y'all are back on the baseline. You're at the serves line. We're going to do cross-court alternate. Okay? And what they're going to do is, I'm a big proponent of, you create, there's two holes in doubles. What's one hole? Anybody? Down the middle. All right? What's the other hole? If you're playing us, what's the other hole? Tasha, Natty, go move over there. Move with your partner, Natty, or Tasha. Good. She just moved with her partner, Natty. Okay, where's the other hole? Right down the line. Okay? Now, Tasha, scoot right over here. Just stay there, Natty. Don't move with her. Now, where's the hole? Down the middle. There's two holes in doubles always. You got to find the... If you're playing a team like us, there's a big hole down the line a lot of times. And then that's why we practice covering the line, because we're going to mix it up. We're going to pick and choose when they're going to be there. Okay? Now, what we're going to do is, though, in volleying, we don't like to hit the tee as a volley. Okay? Now, earlier in the figure eight, when the ball bounced, we could hit the tee as a ground stroke, as a topspin ground stroke, because people are backing up. But right now, Tasha's going to volley, and she's going to go with Mary. Mary's going to be great here. And Tasha is going to, if she hits it to her forehand, then she's going to make her hit a backhand. And she's trying to create a hole without changing the direction. So she's making the person get from this side to this side to this side. Okay? All right, let's see it, Tosh. And as soon as they're done, then Natty and her partner can go. All right, they're done. Next two up. Go in, Marcelli. Okay. We're going to see what we can get here. Good. She got it to the middle. Good. There's a hole right there. And if she gets the next ball, it's going back. So without changing the direction at the tee, she's trying to create a hole. The ground stroker's goal needs to be, the volleyer needs to be their best friend. The volleyer needs, Mary, good movement forward. Okay, that was a little deep. She's trying to volley short in that service box. Okay. Not bad, and the next one's gonna go back out wide. We call this alternating, okay? And that's a great short volley. Just by hitting the short volley, she automatically hit a winner, okay? It's out wide, now she's gonna look to go towards the middle. There's your winner right there. So volleying short, making them alternate is good. We do many variations of this, and we call this alternating. So the only time we're going to change directions is if the ball is high, okay? All right, so stop for a second, ballers. If the ball is high while you're doing this, you can take it down the line. And our saying is, high, you die. Because when it's high, we're going to take it down the line, and if she's hitting it, she's going to aim right out there by that stick, by that corner, like she's serving out wide and doubles. All right, let's see it, Marcelli. Let's see what you got, you and Mary. Battle on. High, you die. Boom, points over. Okay, she changed directions, but she was on top of the net. Okay. That's her time to change, okay? And so now it's a little bit like Kent is, you have to teach them great hustle, great volley. You have to teach them how to make choices. So we have to teach them how to recognize that the ball is high. And when the ball is high, we have to teach them how to move through the ball, okay? What do you think they do when the ball is high? Most players. They stand there and they swing at it, or I use this term in my notes as a Texas fly swatter. I'm from Texas, so I can make fun of Texans, okay? And the racket gets real big and their feet don't move. All right, so let's stop here real quick. Let's have you go over there real quick. Or you just stay over here on the side. Move those right there, Tracy, the single sticks. You are just over here. Coach, you can feed a high flow. But feed over here, Deuce side. Move those sticks right there, Tiff. That's it. Deuce side. You're just picking up. Real quick, yeah. All right, real quick. A line behind Tiff at no man's land. Coach is going to feed you the high volley down the line. Okay? So when you hit the high volley down the line, guess what we want to do? We want to move our feet through it. You're gonna get one ball, okay? So we want to step behind step, good. I was so proud of Mary. Mary was in Nebraska 2 weeks ago, and Nebraska was 25 in the country, and she gets this high floater volley in singles. And next thing you know, here she comes, and she's like, the ball went over, the girl got a racket on it, but it wasn't coming back, okay? So you have to commit your feet through it. Feed them a little shorter so they can move all the way through it. There you go, perfect. Okay? And so that's the one big key is that they don't, can you feed a little shorter? There you go, feed a little shorter. Is the one big key is they gotta get there when the ball is high, and if you do, you're gonna go all the way there. We do this drill in some form every day, okay? And then their target is always the service line, and their target's like you're serving at your wide. That's a great target tip. And now you're noticing where they're finishing to the net. So you gotta practice recognizing this. All right, that's good. Okay, let's do some lob volley. Okay. So in that drill, we always do high, you die. Now, what we're gonna do is, we're gonna work on the lobs. I found the easiest way to work on the lobs, particularly in working with juniors, is everybody's got this Western grip, so the only lob they know how to hit is a topspin lob. So therefore, if you make them hit a lob volley, now we're starting to work on our lobs. Our lobs have improved drastically. This side's hitting the lob, and we want two steps and a kick, and then they're working on staying in there and playing at it, because most people, when they hit a lob, what do? They run backwards. Oh my gosh, I hit a lob, I gotta run, I gotta get off the court. If you hit a lob, you better stay in there, you're in control. Good. Okay, just stay in that line there, Chloe. Chloe, stay in that line. Lily, stay in that line there, there you go. Just switch in and out there, there you go. So they're gonna volley halfway in the middle of the box, work on doing it, and then they're working on their reactions right here. Mary, stay right out there. Just stay in the alley and switch in and out there, there you go. Not behind her, Mary, in the off the court. So Mary's gonna wait off the court. There you go. Normally we do this four in a court. So if you had like eight on the court, then she goes in, they wait off, that way they can rotate in. Good. Good. And the good news is she stayed in there, okay? And if we're staying in there, now we're gonna have a play on the ball. If we turn and run, and then the ball hits the net tape and trickles over, we don't have a play in it. We turn and run and they shank the ball, we don't have a play in it. So this is a good way. Also, some of your men's groups really might like this because it's a little aggressive. Now, the other thing is a good lob is one you make them hit. So if they're trying to, Tracy, stop for a second. Move out of the way, Mary. All right, Tracy, how tall are you? Okay, she looks taller than that, but to me, everybody looks tall. All right, so Tracy's nickname is Orange Crush, even though she's from Seattle and wanted the Seahawks to win, but we're gonna let that be okay. All right. So, if I'm trying to lob over Tracy, what is going to happen to that lob? It will not go in. It will go 2 to 3 feet long, okay? So, my goal when I lob, now obviously she's going to move up, is always the service line and high, and that ball will typically carry some. But if I'm trying to go over their head, I'm hitting a lob that's out. If I hit a lob that's out, I lose the point. A good lob is one you make them hit. Okay, so what we do is we tell them, Tracy, stay there at the service line. Now you're gonna play it out. Come on here, JoJo. All right, JoJo's gonna feed her up there. When she hits her lob, she's aiming at, JoJo, you got intimidated. I intimidated you. The pressure was on, JoJo. Everybody's got nicknames too. So, not bad. Now, we also don't wanna miss later on. So we want them to stay up there. Go one more time. JoJo, show me this. You got this. Oh, that's actually a great lob. A great lob is one that goes over and in. A good lob is one you make them hit. But you got to be aiming at the lobber. If you're aiming over the lobber, it's going long and it does you no good. So that's our big point right there, okay? So, any questions on that? All right. Next up. Gotta read my notes. Okay, does anybody know Greg Patton? Okay, he's got a game called Dingles. Y'all know that game? My team loves that game. I hate that game. I hate that game because we don't play doubles from the baseline. Okay, we teach them to come to net. So we got a game. We haven't figured it out yet what the name is. Coach wants to call it Blingles because the girls like the bling stuff. All right, so we got two down there. Where are my servers? Nagy, you and Lily are serving down here. Tasha, you and Marcelli go down there. Tracy, who are you with? You and Tiff are down here, go down there and return. Okay? And, all right. Huh? Who are you with, Mary? There you go, down here with Tracy.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Okay, so basically, it's and that's what I'm saying. Any drill that you take and you like and you want your personality, take and modify it to fit you. So again, we don't play points from the baseline, so it does us no good. So what we do is they both have one serve. They both serve at the same time. They both must serve and volley. They both are playing the point cross court. When it gets down to one ball, then it's game on, okay? All right, let's see if they can do it with pressure on. They missed it, so now they're just playing a doubles point. Good, I love it, great lob, and I like a swing and a kick. She's gonna miss the overhead, don't turn and run, and then work on that. Just do 2 points and switch. So, normally, go, you're good, Mary. Nope, okay. I'll let them switch sides there. Oh, the pressure serve. So this is good too for pressure serves, because again, now I'm going, they are getting nothing out of practice because you're not getting the serve in. What you get in a match, how many times y'all practice serves and like, you're hitting out of the basket and they're boom, boom, as soon as you start playing it. Oh, I can't get it in. And then they start doing this. Practice what you're gonna get in, okay? So we like to do one serve, put some pressure on, that's good pressure. Now it's dingle or, oh, safety first, that was good. I like the positioning right there. So now, the other thing that I find is that a lot of times in practice, I'm always finding what are ways that I can practice serves, what are ways that I can practice returns, and what are ways that we can be competitive. So this is a good way, it puts pressure on both, because if they're not gonna serve and they're not returning, no points are played. And you can say, come on, what are you gonna do in a match, in a big point? Oh, there's a no-brainer. That's down to 1 point. Oh, this is also good because it teaches them to react. And now they're down to one. Now they've got to get back going again. You could do this where you have them stay back, where you have them come up. Good move. Good choice, Mary. We want all of our choices to be automatic. We don't want them to think about it, you know? And so that's why we call them no-brainers. Good, very good. Oh, you turn, and if she turns, I'll have a ball and I'll hit a ball at her. She's gonna get hit by someone if she turns. You're just lucky I didn't have a ball there, Lily. All right. Oh, and there's a return right there. Look at that, Marcelli. All right, that's good, all right. Let's do Swing-a-Ling real quick, and because I got about 5 minutes. Is that what I have? All right. Okay. What we're gonna do is so we talked a little bit about our system. We want our server's net person on top of the net and going or staying. We want our returner's net person on top of the net. The reason we want them on top of the net is they are the closest to the net. Okay. So they got another 18 feet just to catch up to where they start from, all right? Now, with that said, let's say Tasha is my server's net person, and she covered the line and now she's stuck up at net. Our server is coming in. This is where she's going to stay. She's not gonna close. Now, why is she not gonna get on top of the net? Yes, someone has to cover the lob. So we call this a stagger, okay? And so this drill, and actually, we've got 4 freshmen on the team, and they love this because they're like, they've never seen it, and they did. We call this Swing-a-Ling, and it works on covering the lob, okay? So, you get back up to the baseline, coach, okay? So, coach is gonna feed it down the line with pace to Tasha, she's gonna cover down the line. Then he's gonna feed a ball to Nat, and she's gonna have to do her keeping and play volley. Then he might throw in the lob. When he throws in the lob, she's got to cross over and get it. Cross over. Now, Tasha, what are you doing? And she's gonna stay right here because we wanna be on the same half. We don't want Tasha to move way over here so we have the Grand Canyon hole. We don't want the size of the Grand Canyon, okay? So Tasha's gonna stay there and then they're gonna play it out. Now, if they volley deep, coach can volley it back. So it's fun for me to volley and play in, right? I like to play in, don't I? But the problem is, if I'm playing in, they're not winning the volley. When they hit a volley, when Tasha hits a volley, we want her winning the point. We want it short, okay? When she hits a volley, she's keeping it in play and maybe making him alternate. All right, here we go. So this is what we call swing-a-ling. She's keeping it in play. There it is. Good. All right, and then Maddie, you go up, you go in, and we can rotate this around. So we can let everybody practice this. And again, I have all these on a email for those that want these. Oh, see, she let that ball drop. So that very second drill, we're on top of the net. She let the ball get below the net. Okay. And a lot of times, this person pulls back. So that's why we want this person pulling up. So we always want one person on top of the net. Oh, coach, I think JoJo's cheating. Good, but she hit. So if this person starts cheating, coach, don't feed it on the second ball or third ball. You might feed two or three. So you can bury this up. You might do another one. Oh, yeah. All right, so why do we take the swing volley down the line? Because if I hit it cross court, if I don't hit a winner, now we have to shift it. Now we're totally out of position again. So when we're in a defensive position, when we're moving back, that's why we keep the ball the same direction, okay? So, and then also, everything we practice is high, you die. So if that ball's a little short, we're moving through it, and we have 100%, that is our spot. I don't care if they're there. We're gonna practice where we can hit it on the dime. Because also, most players are runners, and they go to the open court. You just hit behind them, and then you win a point, or singles or doubles. So, all right. Any questions? I'm not sure. Where am I at with time? 10 minutes. Okay. So, what questions do you have for me? Anybody? Yes. Okay. His question is, if our returner is way up, you're talking about the returner, right? A returner's net person. So if the returner's net person is way up, that return needs to go cross court or it needs to be a lob. Then if my returner's net person's at the tee and hugging the middle, now that's when we say isolate. So if we know it's a weak second serve, you're working with your men's team, take it down the line, isolate, but you need to tell that person. Okay, I had one girl that used to do this every time she's gonna hit down line, okay? Sometimes say, hey, and I'd say ice. They know if I say ice, right, I might say find the other hole because everybody's always hitting at the tee. And I'm like, there's another hole down the line. That girl's already left. I mean, she's gone to Kansas and you're still hitting it cross court. So hit that down the line. So yes, if we are going down the line, they need to be back here in this position. And that's why we did that other drill. And their eyes are really looking at it. And the big key is the eyes of what this person does is huge. So her eyes are at coach, okay? If the ball does get past coach, then she's up because she'd moved with the ball and her eyes are back there. Let's do crunch real quick. You wanna do crunch real quick? And then we'll do it. This is a great, some of you have probably already done this drill, and then a lot of times when I have drills, I'm like, the kids are like, I wanna do this drill. I'm like, well, what name is that? What is that drill? Because every drill has a different name, okay? I love this for working on the eyes. Now, at the Air Force Academy, we have a vision lab. And this is one of the things that you could actually have your people work on, though, is that when a ball comes at you, relax your eyes. If your eyes tense, you do this. So when I do those serving drills, I'm relaxing the eyes. So you as a teaching pro could be back here. All right, go. Okay, we call this crunch. So she's working. Now she needs to move back and her eyes. That's the one thing we don't want to do. I need you moving back and eyes forward. Okay, do that again. So the idea is, if the ball's on that half, and it's over there, she's gonna move up and be on that half, okay? When the ball's behind her and she can't see it, we do not wanna turn around. We do not wanna watch and see what kind of great shot Mary Myers is gonna hit, because she hits a great shot. But I don't wanna watch that. I wanna be watching that person. And if I'm watching that person, and Tasha looks like this, show me Tasha, be mean. I'm like, oh my gosh, and I'm getting back to here. And as soon as she hits, I'm gonna stop. But if Tasha's, you know, just kind of hanging out, then when I'm right here, now I'm just gonna hover more, okay? So in our lab, we work on keeping our head still. We work on relaxing our eyes. So when you're the returner's net person, your eyes is back or your eyes are forward. And I just didn't have very good grammar there. All right, who's starting the ball? Trey, okay, so Natty's back. All right. She's looking at Tasha. Go. Okay, Maddie's up. She's looking at Tasha. Very good. And notice that she was stepping forwards that time. She didn't have to turn and watch back. Watch her and see what she does here. Up, now she's feeding it. She's gonna go. Now she's back, she's looking at Tosh. Okay, she's looking at Tosh. Now she's up, trying it. Now she needs to be back, look at Tosh. And then you rotate around. Okay, so we call this crunt. And the idea is when you can see the ball, be on top of the net. When you can't see the ball, get back as far as you can. Okay, good. She's eyes, good. Lily has good eyes. Good. Lily's gonna go up. Oh, Lily, better. Oh, good play. Lily's on that half. Now she's gonna get back. And then watch your head and watch your eyes. It's a good game to work on that right there. Okay. So going back to your question, this is it's a fun game to end on if you want to end on games on your lessons and things like that. But particularly when the beginner's working on this, a lot of times I'll stand behind and I'll push them in front or say back, up, 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 back. So you can do this with all levels. You can do this with young kids, you can do this with the ladies. Probably with the ladies, again, this is getting used to, do you see the ball? If you see the ball, you're not gonna get hit. It's when you don't see the ball, usually when you get hit. Okay, Chloe gets eyes back. All right, another question. Anybody else have another question? Okay, and with that, all right, go ahead and stop here for a second. Tiff is going to start here. Chloe, come up to net. Be over there. Be the server's net person. So if Tiff is the returner's net person, okay, she's going to call the line. Let's say we know she's going down the line. And again, she's going to move up when they hit it at her, after they hit it at her. If the ball gets past her, she's going to move over here, and it basically creates a triangle. And we have two triangles, okay? So this is the start of my triangle. If I hit at her, okay, I'm gonna move up, look to go, and then I'm gonna go here because I'm gonna volley here. Okay, now I gotta get back, and then I'm gonna go back to my triangle movement. So your movement's always at V's. So I like, most people move at an L. Do you know what an L is? Everybody knows the L step. L's for losing. If you wanna lose, do the L step. If you wanna win, do the B step. Everything's at a V. So we're always, I like to be here at this angle, I like to be here at this angle, I like to be here and go back this way. So everything is at a V in how you move. So it's the same thing in doubles when you play with a net. So, all right, what else? All right, let's do the one we did yesterday with the two on the baseline, with the lob. All right, one of the things, coach, you can play in. All right, down, two down here, one down there, there you go. All right, so this is another game that you can play. One of the things we like to do is have them take the ball out of the air, okay? Because when the ball is bouncing, we've given up all our positioning. So, basically, if you're going to start the ball at the lob has to be past the service line. Okay, JoJo, you know what we're doing? Good, all right. If you win the point, you have to go back and touch the baseline, and the losing team feeds in a lob. The lob has to be back the service line. We want them hitting a swinging volley, an overhead, or the ball on the rise. The only spot we don't want this person to do is to move back. Right, JoJo? You don't move back. Okay? All right. So, as soon as they go, so you got to be ready. Oh. So, if you win the point, you have to touch the baseline. That's a good lob, Tracy, good lob. And then that team behind there feeds that lob so it can go quick or slow. And so it works on, so they didn't have to move much because they missed that first ball. Oh, they didn't have to move much, touch it, there you go. She hits it on the rise. Good, come back. JoJo, way to be moving forward, good job. Oh yeah, so now they know lob's going in, lob's going out, and it makes those feeders because how many people don't know how to hit a lob? I mean, that drives me crazy too. So this is a good drill just for the feeders of, you gotta get the lob past the service line, and you don't wanna be wasting that lob either. There's a no-brainer, good job, JoJo. And she's gotta still run, her partner helped her out. Yeah, there it is, nope, now they gotta run quick.
Yeah, JoJo got to help her out. All right, we'll get him up. Any questions on that drill? That's kind of a fun game, but again, it can be slow, it can be fast, and then once this stone gets into stress, but again, our goal is, if you're playing doubles, let's get the ball in the air. If you're playing it out soon, let's get that ball in the air. Let's not hit anything. But a lot of different things of, they're working on lobs. I still think the lob is one of the greatest shots in tennis. It's not used enough, and you can continue to use it and allows them to work on it. All right, y'all wanna get these up real quick? So, any other questions? All right, they wanna play with, all right, before you get them up, we'll do psycho real quick. One last, this is kind of a singles game. This is basically based off this singles game. So we took this game kind of based off of this. It's psycho, there's a dozen different names for it. You might have a different name for it, but we call it psycho at the Air Force Academy for some reason. Basically, if you got four down here, we're gonna have five down here and five down here. If you win all 5 points, you have a point for your team. And as soon as the point's over, the person behind them is gonna come in and feed. So again, it's a fun way to finish on a high energy note. I love to finish practice on something high energy and fun. So they love this. The only thing I'm not a fan of is there's no serves and returns. So she feeds in the ball and right away, she can feed it anywhere. They got 2 points. All right. Oh, they got 3 points. Okay, and then she stays in. Oh, they got 2 down there. They're trying to get 5 points. So the feeder from behind comes right back in, and it's real high energy, gets a lot of movement. Because that next person can feed wherever they're at. Great job, Mary. Oh, Mary! Oh, good effort. So still, you could go for sometimes 3-5 minutes and not have a point. So again, it's teamwork. Are you gutting it up? Oh, so she's got 1. So they're back to 0. Up, oh, back to 0. All right, and we'll stop there. All right, go ahead and pick these up real quick. Any questions on that? Y'all come on this side here.